Hard work, ingenuity and ambition. All things you'll find in abundance amongst the 15 million people of Shanghai over there to our southeast. And we've got plenty of that here on the grid as well. 20,000 horsepower, give or take, chomping at the bit to be unleashed for the Chinese Grand Prix. We start a lap here at Shanghai with the long, difficult right-handers of turns 1 and 2, the first of 16 corners that make up this 3.3-mile circuit. The incredibly long back straight provides the best passing opportunity of the lap with speeds in excess of 200 miles per hour before the braking zone of turn 14. Joining me for the Grand Prix once again is Anthony Davidson. Now I want to ask you about Kimi Raikkonen. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
There are never any guarantees in this business, but certainly the performance last time out would have boosted their confidence coming into this one.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. Sebastian Vettel will start on pole. Fantastic qualifying from the multiple world champion. And starting alongside is Fernando Alonso. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Ricciardo, Sergio Perez, and Ocon, Verstappen, Magnussen, Grosjean, and Charles Leclerc, Hamilton, Hülkenberg, Carlos Sainz, and a McLaren, Bottas, Ericsson, Pierre Gasly, and Lance Stroll, Hartley, and Sergei Sirotkin rounds off the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Virtual safety car has been deployed. We need to keep a positive delta here. Slow down, maintain a positive delta. Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. Softs. is now enabled and will be available to use when you are within 1 second of the car ahead in the DRS zone. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Copy. Box. Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. Let me know you're all right. Exit now. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Is 14.6 seconds. Has come in and fitted the soft tire. in the pits. Is 5.7 seconds. Nice work, that brings you up the place. The position. That's us down the place. What happened? Let me know you're okay. Check your MFD. straight ahead is 29.3 seconds. Is 6.1 seconds. So we've been looking at the damage, and we think you should be okay to continue. It'll cost us a little bit of time, but we're nearly at the end of the race. Engine off. This is your final lap. Final lap of the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. Okay, that was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. Top job, my friend, top job. I was a bit worried about this one at the start of the weekend, but you pulled through. Thank you.
McLaren have pulled it off. They've won in spectacular fashion here today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. It's a good result for Kimi Raikkonen, who extends his advantage at the top of the championship. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Oh, maybe Marcus Ericsson? Yes, I think I'll commit to that one. Marcus Ericsson, fine job, very consistent.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Sauber, whose good result moves them further up the championship. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye, and see you again next time.
good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. It looks like your arrival is schooling you a bit. You had a few bumps and scrapes today. Who would you say is at fault? Well, thanks anyway.
That's a great result. You did really well. I don't think we can have any complaints with that performance.
We've received invitations to new historic events. You'll be able to choose whether or not to participate before the end of this weekend.
If it were me, this is probably what I'd invest in.